chop his head for a souvenir. He want war chop his head for a souvenir. Big bands in the party, the rose in here. Ooh. He with that lion eating, nigga, he hella weird. Snitch, yeah, niggas on his grind, got him out of here. Put deck on his saw legs, wobble, wobble. Lil' bitch got me buying, bitch, gobble, gobble. Bob. Must be goofy if you think I'm a scrapple hollow. You might later see the day, won't see tomorrow.
If you ain't gang, then you a lame, you ain't getting no passes. I heard the ops in this bitch, so let's get shit bracket. And if it's by the bag, then me and my comrades at it. And weed is not a drug, I am not no addict. Big guns on the ground, but he ain't gon' shoot. Y'all got jumped up by them boys and he told on you.
What?
Oh, damn, that's too bad for you. Just cause our moms know each other, I don't make us boo. Finesse my baby mama, cause we don't play by rules. Good jizz going up, trying to make some bands. And I only started rap so I could fuck my fans. Your favorite rapper started rap so he can make more friends. Dumb, stupid, little dork. He thought hating was gonna help, it didn't work. No. His bitch all in my DMs, like, let's work. I'm a jerk. He said his word, but now he on the shirt.
He want war, chop his head for a souvenir. Big bands at the party, the rose in here. Ooh. He with a lion yeeting, nigga, he hella weird. Snitch, niggas on his grind, got him out of here. Put deck on his saw legs, wobble, wobble. Lil' bitch got me buying, bitch, gobble, gobble. Bob. Must be goofy if you think I'm a scrapple hollow. You might later see the day when we see tomorrow.
I was broke a while ago, now they pay for the features. They study everything I do, you should call me a teacher. Fight who or what hands, you are not my brother. No. Putting feet up on his face, disrespectful mother. Fuck bitches, get money, that's just how I feel. Yeah. He said he want a war with me, then he mentally ill. Stupid. He be tricking on these hoes, but won't spend on his bros. What? You still living with your granny, you are not the GOAT. On the gang, we the gang that's causing pollution. R.I.P. Eazy-E, we should sign with Ruthless. This the bra in front of me, I'ma leave you toothless. He said he could've called me slipping, then came up missing. I said his money on the flow, this drip is expensive. Time is money, and my time is not to be wasted. And I ain't always had a bag, I had to be patient. Front lining in this war, this game related.
He want war, chop his head for a souvenir. Big bands at the party, the rose in here. He with that lion yeeting, nigga, he hella weird. Snitch, niggas on his grind, got him out of here. Put deck on his saw legs, wobble, wobble. Lil' bitch got me buying, bitch, gobble, gobble. Bob. Must be goofy if you think I'm a scrapple hollow. You might later see the day when we see tomorrow.
Yeah, man, what's going on, y'all? It's Jenna Marco. I got my big bro, Moneyville Dot in the building.
Oh, yeah, Moneyville Dot, a.k.a. King Dot, formerly known as that. Yeah, all that and some more shit. What's going on, bro?
Too much time. We're just going to jump straight into it a little.
Let's go.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about yourself, Moneyville Dot. What's going on with you? What you coming with? Where are you from? You feel me?
I was originally born in Linwood, California. Like San Francisco Hospital. From there, I was living in like I was living in the Jordan Down Projects. You feel me? Like where the great streets at and shit. Up until I was about like six type shit. And then my mom moved me out towards like the Inland Empire. I was out there for a minute, like Rialto. You know, back and forth type shit. But you know, that's me. And then I got into music, so shit. What am I bringing? No, I'm bringing like you know that energy. Like that personality, you know, that I'm like the, well, fuck with Macy, I'm like Diddy 2.0, just without the,
just without fucking niggas off the money type shit.
Yeah, you feel me? But, you know, I'm just bringing character. That's to draw it all down, I'm just bringing character, man, me, to the world.
And that's as real as it get, you hear me? He said, I'm like a Diddy 2.0, just not without the money.
I want people to get theirs.
So tell us about the single that you just performed, one of your more intimate tracks, I like to say, you know what I mean? Yeah. A little on the personal side of it.
Yeah, honestly, that song came from like a D space. It was cool because I had the beat and the person on the hook, we was like this at the time, and I'm like, bro, if you ain't gonna do nothing, like write no music, at least do this hook for me. I'm trying to get you on the album. So he wrote the hook or whatever, and I was like, oh shit. And it, like from that hook, y'all got the rest, but it just fit. We was going through a lot, beefing with people type shit, personal shit. Like it felt like a real life war out there type shit. So it just came at the right hand. Like the stuff in there is all facts. Me, what I say about my baby mama cousin, like that whole shit was a story. It was gonna be a war, like in this family type shit. So it came from a deep space because it's, you know, it ain't just a song, it's life. But I fuck with the song. I didn't think it was gonna get the attraction it got.
I would say that War definitely one of my favorite tracks by you.
Yeah.
It's always real shit that make good music. You know what I mean? And that's just the way it always go, man.
Yeah. That's what's up.
Like you were saying earlier, you was like formerly known as King Dot. Let's talk a little bit about Moneyville and why the name changed from King Dot to Moneyville Dot.
Well, I was trying to figure out, like, man, bro, I was getting traction, but I be trying to use my songs on stories to bring people in rails and stuff. And I type in King Dot and it's pop up Kendrick Lamar because that was his name before.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, whatever going on with that, I just said, I'm tired of having to type my full name in
right.
for a motherfucker to get to my music site. They got to type in my name plus the song. No.
Exactly.
So I have to stand out here and shit. I am Moneyville when it comes down to it. Like, whether I got a whole team, no team, I'm Moneyville.
Exactly.
So I put it behind my name. I'm going to hold it down, and it's going to hold me down. So, shit, I'm going to just rock with that.
That leads into my next question. Perfect, actually. How can I or how can somebody get to Moneyville? Where is Moneyville at?
Shit, Moneyville, bro, is Moneyville is like everything for real. It's a feel. You ever been in them, like a whole like it's like bad like been in your bag type shit.
Mm-hmm.
Just wherever your like dreams is. That's why on the logo it say Moneyville. You know where your dreams is only as big as your grind. If you grind hard. And you gonna get everything you feel. You gonna feel like you're in Moneyville. It ain't even just about the money, cause you know we always rich at heart, spirit, and all that.
You feel me?
But like I said, that's my label. It wasn't. It's not my original label though. So that hack came from somewhere too.
So how'd that go? What's the original?
So my original label was Blood Money. You feel me?
Okay.
And there was a point in time when Gang got through his little contract. You know the artist Gang. We from the same neighborhood or whatever. And he was looking for a new label, and I didn't know none of the business stuff I'd be telling all the people I talked to.
Right.
So I never did the business part of that. I'm just running with it, building this name, and he came with his label, Blood Money, because
mm-hmm.
one of our big homies was tagging me on the post when he was like, oh, I'm looking for these people, and he had tagged me. So I felt like bro was on my shit. You know, I ain't gonna smut buddy name, but I feel like bro was on my shit, and instead of putting a little homie on, nigga just stole from a nigga, but I can't be mad because it's business.
Exactly.
And once I learned business, shit, I just go. So I just recreate it. It ain't nothing wrong with it. It's always good to recreate whenever you get in a tough spot. It might be the best move. Some people, like, hold on to their old shit because they feel like it's going, like, it's changing them. But
right.
No, it's just growing.
Nah, yeah, I feel like rebranding is always good. You already know how I went through my whole name change evolution from the point where I was in my early teens to now me being 18.
Yeah.
Where I'm at now, man, it's just, it's wild, man.
Yeah.
What motivates you to make music? And if anyone, who is an artist, dead or alive, that you would like to work with?
Oh. I want to be answering these questions in order, but what motivates me for sure is my kids.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not gonna lie, I got a teenager daughter. I'm not saying it just because it sound cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's really my kids, bro. I'm Mr. Fuck Them Kids at that too, but I love mine. I got a 13-year-old daughter now, and you know the kids is on the internet tough.
Right.
And then her brother like 15, so it's like it's really them
mm-hmm.
that's motivating me, because if they not fucking with it, then it's like fuck like anything else.
Exactly.
They're on the internet tough. They're on TikTok, Facebook. Not even Facebook, that sound old for them. They on Instagram. They own these shit. They on. But I be playing the game with them and they be talking that shit, but they motivate me to still be on it. Then there's a few people like, you know, my baby moms and stuff like that. And just the people I lost in life that I made promises to that always motivate me. And it's not just for the music, it's just for anything I do, just to keep going. And artist-wise, working with, man, I ain't gonna lie, I felt like PNB Rock, I wanted to work with that man, bro. Like, when I was in prison, I listened to that. That's when I really started listening to his music and shit. And that nigga got a soulful voice that I fuck with type shit. I want to work with Kels, but if that's the stuff with him didn't happen, I would definitely want to work with R. Kelly.
Right.
I want to work with Jermaine Dupri producer-wise,
mm-hmm.
like one of my best producers, man. It's other, but yeah, them my top people and shit. Independent-wise, I feel like I work with who I want to,
mm-hmm.
like that. I don't feel like it ain't nobody I wanted to work with yet.
I mean, like, okay, so like with that being said, you know what I mean, we gonna you feel me, these folks that you want to work with, or these folks that you're going to work with, because you ain't say nobody dead, you know what I'm saying?
I would have said Biggie, but no offense. You listen, I fuck with Biggie, but I don't hate the shit he was saying in his songs. You know, he want to run up in people's house, kidnap moms and fuck shit. Nah, we going to get blackmarked quick in this day and age.
Yeah, you feel me?
So, it's just, I don't know, damn. I would do a song with Pac. I don't know how it would go, because he's versatile, but I ain't no big Pac fan, how they feel like I should be because I'm from the West Coast. But I'm not no huge Pac fan, but I feel like, man, we can make a banger. And I did say somebody did, because PNB Rock is dead.
Oh, yeah, uh-huh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Damn,
Jay, come on. Nah, I still can't believe that.
It's still fresh.
I still can't believe it. Bag Season. Last year, you dropped Bag Season Chapter 1. Damn. Bunch of features, you feel me? Pookie, yeah. FN Rule, yeah. Fast Pace, Myself, just to name a couple, you know what I'm saying? What was that like? What was the traction like on that? How do you feel like the people received it? What was the process of making the project like?
That project took, I want to say, just the thought process for that shit, like, just want to do it, took between 2 to 3 years. I started working on that shit like 2019, 20, type of COVID type shit.
Yeah.
It was, I just let that shit go. Like, I fucked with people. I really took my time with the beats, getting to know the producers, my engineer. Like, I was real strict on who I worked with while I was in, like, fuck a single while I'm in studio. Like, if I go to somebody's studio, I'm making sure it still gets my engineer, because it all has to get, you know, together. And shit, the artists I work with, I personally know them or met them. You know, I met you at a show.
Yeah.
Like, off top, we hit the, like, hey come outside, bro. Yeah, like,
yeah, come
I
on.
Fucked with you. And I think, what, you were 16 at the time?
I think I might have been 15.
15, ooh.
Yeah, I think, yeah, I might have been, like, 15.
Energy
at the time
was crazy. So I'm like, we gotta work. And I told you I put you on the track because it wasn't what you was gonna normally get on.
Exactly.
And I wanted to push that type shit. And then with King Beyond, you know, that was like, that's my peoples. So I just wanted to push him. Everybody just, I don't know, everything came just apart.
I will always leave it to you and to fucking Riavelli to make some ratchet shit happen in the studio. And that's one thing.
We still gotta get something going.
Because
we still gotta get some shit, though.
Y'all the only two motherfuckers that are really like, man, it's the type of music.
Hey, one of crazy. I just got asked today, like, this shit go, break it down, hoe, but we need some new shit.
Yeah.
So I'm finna put that together.
Yeah, what's it called? I was gonna say, during that time, I feel like motherfuckers definitely had a lot of time to develop a whole lot of growth. Like, mm-hmm. It's a lot of shit that you just go back and listen to and be like, man, maybe if that was right now, I would've did this different, that different.
I think that's
the beautiful part of the grind and the process, is to be able to look back on the project and be like, all right, now it's time to take an even bigger step up from this.
I feel like with that, that's the first project I put out that I was really, like, satisfied with. It's the first one I put up under King Dot. Well, now it's under Moneyville Dot now. So it's the first one I put under, like, in years since I, like, really started just dropping singles, getting the feel back because of, like, what I was going through in life. So it was easy because it was my life. The shit I was talking about on Rich Mo, I literally had... like people like Fast Pace helped me even put the track list. All that shit was important. So I knew it was gonna be received the way it should be because it was put together with like honesty, love,
right,
real opinions and shit like that. Like it was not no, yeah, fuck with you, bro. Like this shit trash. Like, you know, it was a time we had small studio sessions and big studio sessions.
Literally.
You know, and it was like a time where I even had to say, nah, fuck that. Let me write that verse again.
Yeah,
and change the whole verse or
fix it.
Yeah, so it was a lot of, it felt like what I always seen coming up, watching documentaries of Puff Daddy and them. Mm-hmm. It just felt that it was just a good aura.
One.
Yeah, with me.
When can we, if so, can we expect Bag Season Chapter 2? Like, is that something that's gonna be ongoing?
Yeah, nah, for sure. I'm definitely planning on that, but I'm working on something else right now. So, you know, it's one of those, like, in-between type shit.
Do you care?
I want to know.
Do you care to?
So, I'm working on a project called That's On My Mama's Son, and it's a, like, I forgot the words where it's, like, whatever. But it's funny because I'm the only child. Yeah, so when I be like, that's on my mama's son, nigga, and the fuck motherfucker up, like, but you your mama only son type shit, so yeah, I be putting it on me, so some shit. Like cocky shit, just yeah. To throw motherfuckers, just different. So I got a couple like tracks, I ain't gonna lie, I did record one song type shit, but I'm still debating, like if it's gonna fit for that particular project, I might hold that motherfucker for back season two, but then they won't get that until November. It's for sure, I'm trying to work on that, that's the thing, like, I am trying to work on that for November, so hopefully, but I'm gonna give it to them before the year up, back season two.
You said that you're an only child, what's it called?
Yeah, on my mama's side.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, so you have siblings on the other side.
Yeah, I'm the baby on my daddy's side, though, but so it's like, yeah.
So you grew up with moms mainly then?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, what's that like? How would you really, like, describe that? Like, would you say that you ever wished for a sibling, or at times it might have been, like, lonely-ish? And, like, how does that experience of kind of, like, walking through the world on your own and being a young black man raised by a woman, and how that play all back into your music?
Man, bro. My mom... All right, so my dad died before I was born, so I would... It's like, that's the only side I was ever gonna get to know type shit is my mom type shit. So that leads to part where I had a little space that's not from... That's not from the LA area, you know, but she was tough coming from, like, I was born, like, you know, back then, so she was going through shit as a kid to where she told herself she would never want to put her kid through that shit. So I come from a strict, she loved the hell out of me, like, but it's strict.
Mm-hmm.
She was playing.
I know what that
is. I feel like when I'm gonna make sure my mama see this shit, because I felt like with her, because we don't got a good relationship, but we do. She played more the father side than that mother side type shit. Because she didn't want me to be soft and shit, blah, blah, blah. But, yeah, that shit kind of drove a nigga away. But it drove a nigga to, like, a fucked up mental at the same time to run away. Like, once I got to the age, like, you know them kids, like, I can't wait to run away. Like, I was a bitch to do it, actually, as a kid type shit. But I'm like, when I'm grown, nigga, fuck it, you can't tell me nothing.
Right.
But I just drew that shit into music. Then I lost my grandma. So I was raised by her and my grandma because she couldn't get off the titties. So she stayed wherever my grandma was staying, like, type shit, for real. So it made a nigga tough. Like, you know, it's just with anything, like, if it probably wouldn't matter what parent I live with, it could have been the environment.
Mm-hmm.
But then, like, my mama, clean household, kept food in the house, cooked. I ain't never seen her go to work. That's all I'm gonna say. Like, I don't think she was doing illegal shit, but I don't know what she was doing. Like, but I'm like, she's not like no whole shit. Like, my mama whole dyke, like, young mimes, like, so I know for sure, like if anything, it was hella females in the house type shit. That's why I love the ladies. But, but, like, for real though, it was cool. It's ups and downs type shit. Like I said, it was just strict. So that shit'll break you or make you type shit.
Oh, some shit right here.
Some
what's
shit.
It called? Your radio show that you had rolling. You know what I mean?
Yeah, look, bro.
The folks enjoyed that. You know what I mean? It was a whole lot of ratchet shit going on. You
liked
know?
It
was a whole lot. Yeah, it was a whole lot of messy shit going on. You know what I mean?
That for sure.
Nah, yeah, but what's it called? There's something we really fucked with. Like, can we hope to see anything like that coming back? Like, what was that? Like, what's that whole deal?
I'm gonna keep it real. I want to do it again, but that shit, the way the show was given to me, I felt like it wouldn't be right. That particular show or how it was, if it wasn't with the same people.
Right.
And I had, like, disconnection. I ain't gonna say falling out. I had disconnection with some of the people that, like, within that process. And shit, I just, if we can make it happen, we can make it happen. Or if I gotta go somewhere else, it's just gonna be, like, hard to make sure it's that same shit, because that shit was, like, crazy.
I definitely feel like, I definitely feel like a big benefit of that was that character and personality that you do bring.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It was real personal, had a lot of the homies on there.
Know
what I mean?
It was, like, crazy.
Uh-huh.
Like, it was natural. We lit the interviews. I'm throwing people with questions that's not scripted. None of this shit is real.
I jumped on there a couple times, boy. Nigga, had me on there talking about some shit I told this nigga the other day. Should have never said it. Fuck is you talking about?
I'm telling you. Bro, I think I still got some of them shit either archive or like what, but I do want that shit back because it was like a great vibe, and I'm going to always do anything I do. I definitely want the homies to get in, not because it's going to benefit me, because it's a unity thing. Like, I'm gonna bring you to the table. I'm not gonna wait till you big, nigga. You big to me now, cause you got my attention. So exactly. I'm gonna bring you to the table, like. So I like that natural shit.
One,
as long as it's natural, we gonna always have good and shit. I just honestly, I'm gonna tell you this, cause I try to do shit professional, but honestly, bro. They wanted too much of the, not too much of the show. They wanted too much that the studio wasn't really the installation they wanted. They wanted me to basically do it every 2 weeks. Mm. These motherfuckers wanted it at least once a week.
Right.
You feel me? Mm-hmm. And shit, you know, nowadays with content, that once or every 2 weeks, that shit ain't doing it's for these motherfuckers. Suffice. They want that constant, that shit fire.
Yeah.
That shit stick with you.
You have
that's
to.
What they want. So.
Oh, yeah. So, like,
if I can get that, I gotta have creator control.
Mm-hmm.
That's what that shit like. Nigga, if you gonna let me do this, give me this all through the week, I'm telling you, I'm gonna make you proud.
Exactly. Uh-huh. And I feel like that's always better in terms of the content on the business tip rather than a nigga that'll fall back and let somebody spoon feed on me.
Yeah.
You feel me? And what's it called? Treating the nigga how he wants to or whatever, but don't really know what's going on behind and what niggas is taking and how much is really taken from you.
I don't want to say it just because it's like, I know age-wise, I'm young. I'm like, I'm older.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? But the method that the background team wanted to go with, I felt was old school.
Right.
So me being a hip older person, I didn't want to keep it old school. I know we got to feed these motherfuckers. If I'm willing to feed them, like, let me feed my peoples. Like, it's just like being the artist that you know your peoples want the music, but the label is... Like, nah, like, it make you feel stagnant. Like, it's so much shit goes on every fucking day. Nigga, I'm supposed to wait till, nigga, every 2 weeks I'll be behind. How we gonna grow and get past this? Breakfast Club, all these people, they're putting shit out constantly, bro.
Yeah, every constantly, second of the fucking day.
Nigga, these are our competitors. Whether we're big now or not, these are our competitors.
This exactly.
is why we want to go to. Nigga, we got to get on it.
Exactly.
So I just feel like unless I can get creative control, then shit, I don't know. We ain't gonna, like, I don't know. But I want to do it, though.
Yeah, I heard that, you feel me? Always keep it natural. Keep your creative control.
For
you
show,
feel me? And we
for
like
show.
It comfortable. This family, you feel me?
Yeah.
It's always a good one with my nigga Die, you're me.
You got this last one?
Any last words, you feel me? Anything, anybody you want to shout out, anything we got to look out for coming up? What's the deal?
Oh, yeah. Shout out to my brother Fast Paced, the gang guy. He constantly working. I tell people they don't give him enough, like, respect. Shout out to you. I watch you grow, still watching you grow. Shout out to the whole PRESSED&PRECISE family. You know, I watch y'all grow, watching y'all grow. Shout out to my kids, Princess and Beautiful. Shout out to both my baby mamas, Janae and Nyjah. shout out to my boy King Beyond, you feel me? Shout out to the gang though, you feel me? They know the whole LAC and all that. You know, I'm gonna keep it natural. Shout out to my people, if I didn't say your name, tap in, Mo. But shout out to everybody that fuck with me.
Hey, look, shout out
to me. But look, it's a lot of people out there I do want y'all to see. But for it's me, for the summertime, we finna do some shit. I'm trying to, we finna do the break it down video soon.
Okay.
I don't know what day yet.
And we know that that's going
cool.
Stupid.
Oh, yeah. Pookie don't want to do the pool party shit, but it's needed. I think that's going to be needed.
Why don't want to do it?
I don't know, but that's what's gonna be the video. Crazy pool party. What you think? I wanna try to get everybody to Arizona, Lake Havasu vibes.
Well, it's like
get on that jet ski.
One thing I will say, with like Pookie though, like that nigga, if he talking about something, that nigga better have a bigger idea, you know?
Yeah,
what
no.
I mean?
See what I can say, I can't say too much, I'll tell you off But the ideas they got for the Zodiac video, like, we finna go crazy when we do that one, like.
One.
I think I'm gonna do multiple videos to that one though. Like the party type scene and then the shit they trying to do, because the shit they want to do is more like nigga industry. So, you know, I ain't never mad at it. As long as it don't like fuck up my like character, who I am, who I gotta die as, and who my daughter's gonna keep living, because I don't got sons, but who my daughter's gonna keep name alive. I can't fuck up my character for what nobody else feel.
Nah, yeah.
So, like, but. One thing I could tell people don't like the way Pookie move, for it's like how rude he is and shit, but it's in the name. Like, it's in the name. And I respect my boy. He a good dude. Like, he a good, honest dude. he done got on my ass a few times, and I had to be like, fuck, like, you right. Like, I done passed up opening up for Too Short at, like, the some big-ass arena, like, that's next door to the Staples Center. And I fucked up because I was more worried about, I was being a real nigga, worried about the homie not being able to come, and the homie wasn't responsible enough to get in.
Right.
So, like, I'm like, nah, type shit, but, yeah. He a good dude, so when you get people like that, fuck how they, like, not fuck how they talk, like, be able to communicate with them people, whether it's bad or not, because they getting the job done, and obviously nobody gonna waste their breath on somebody that they don't see can do better.
Exactly.
You know, sometimes it do seem like a motherfucker is nonstop, like, bro, how much time we got? Yes. All right, look, so I'm gonna give you a quick rundown on Pookie. I used to go by the name of K-Dot the Icon. Mm-hmm. You gotta really know a nigga, like, it's jerk era type shit. I never really did jerk music, but I tried. Pookie always been, like, with the parties and shit, he was that nigga, and I'm like, bro, fuck with me. I'm talking about, nigga, the AVs, Joe Moses, YGs, RJs, Nipsey, he done brought them out.
Yeah.
From LA to the IE, he done brought the cities together. This is what he been doing.
Right.
That's why he in Vegas doing it, bringing the city out, bringing Vegas out, bringing them way to out there. This is what Pookie do. It's a person you want to get behind.
Exactly.
Nigga, I'm telling you, door sham. He ain't never really told me I suck. He just was on some, like, just keep going type shit, but he'd be like, it's his reaction. He rude, so, like, I kid you not, bro. I said, you know what? I'm finna send this nigga break it down. He did, I paid him for the hook, right? I don't even know if I ain't gonna tell y'all how much I paid, though, but I paid him for the hook. We went to Sinatra's studio, did his shit, put that shit together. He heard, he said, let me get a verse.
I said, what?
He like, let me get a verse. I said, man, I look at Beyond. Beyond was like on some like up and down shit because in reality, niggas wanted to take blood off. Not me per se, but on some business shit. But I fought to keep that nigga on the verse. Like, but business-wise, I always talk to business like mine people, and like I said, the person Pookie is, I knew, okay, the hook, a nigga gonna share here and there, they on the hook, they gonna hook a verse that they love, you can't never take that away from a nigga. If you love the shit, I know you gonna push it like I push it, and he did, and I got stagnant from that motherfucker, you feel me? So shit, it's people that probably say they know me from him,
yeah.
Like, I don't give a fuck.
It's all about developing those relationships in order to make power moves.
I don't care how a motherfucker know me, nigga. Once you know me, you know me.
Yeah, power moves.
Shit, that's a good trait. You got people like that, you can't be mad. Like, you got to keep him around. Type shit. But yeah, that's a good dude, though.
Thanks for coming to sit with me, you feel me? Bro. Big bro coming out.
You know,
it's
going
to be a good one. Y'all already know what's going on, man.
It's press
season. You feel me? Pressed and Precise, episode 1. Keep your eyes up for the shit we got coming up next. It's finna get crazy out here, man.